our students that come out of here are different and better than any students anywhere in the United States. Why is that the case?
Well, I think their experience here is quite unique. When the students come into this laboratory, they have to build things. They build the facilities, they build the laser diagnostic techniques.
And in fact, everything that we see behind us was built by students, right?
Absolutely. This used to be a storage building, and the students have converted this into a thriving laboratory with support from the Air Force, Navy, and NASA, and private industry. And then when you couple in the laser diagnostic capabilities that we've developed with the chemistry department, it's quite unique.
What's the practical application of this? Obviously, there's some folks interested in it for weaponry. We've heard Russia talk about it. We've heard the Chinese talking about it.
Access to space and return to space is a commercial application of hypersonics, and understanding and optimizing and keeping those vehicles safe for people as they go up and down is important.
Dr. Simon North is the department head of chemistry, and he is the other partner involved in this hypersonic project here. How does chemistry and aerospace engineering mix together on developing these hypersonic vehicles?
That's a good question. So I have a background in sort of understanding how energy is transferred from molecule to molecule. It was sort of a natural collaboration, so we started working together. This is a playground for a chemist. The kind of conditions that Rodney is able to make in all these tunnels are really like nothing else that you can make in a lab anywhere else.
Rodney, what do you think the future of hypersonics is 10, 20, 30 years from now?
Not only at this university, but at universities and national labs around the country, people are making scientific progress. Our computational prediction tools are getting better and better. So I do think efficient hypersonic flight is in our future.